As some know that my father passed away, and w when he passed away, we realized that he had COPD. It's a chronic disorder for the lungs. It's basically like an asthma, but it's like 100 times worse than an asthma. And when you've got COPD, you're basically put on this breathalyzing machine at home for the rest of your life, because it's to do with your lungs and your oxygen. You need extra oxygen and stuff like that. So that's what roughly what COPD is. And think about my dad today, quite a lot today actually. It's inspired me to send out some healing thoughts and healing energy to you, or you may know someone who may have COPD, and then you can share your energy with them just by communicating with them in the same room. So I'm gonna go into a little slight meditation and then build up some energy waves. You can copy me at home. You can do the breathing exercises if you would like to participate. So I'm working with the green energy for the heart chakra here. Archangel Raphael at my side. Archangel Raphael is an archangel working on the green vibration for the heart chakra. He is also your spirit guide for when you travel and you're on your journeys, and he is also a good companionship spirit guide for when you lose someone and you're going through a transition of understanding. And as Archangel Michael has also helped me throughout the 3 years, Raphael has also helped me with guidance over the last few years to help me to understand why my dad's went the way he did. And for me not to be as much upset and tearful as others was and would have been and probably still is. Since my father passed away, I've basically just opened up all my awareness, I suggest. Because it's like I'm not scared even for death myself. Now I understand it's a love vibration when you die, but it's that bit of feeling before you actually go to light, that pain that we all feel as humans, and then we incarnate into another spirit, into another dimension, in another realm, in another experience, but does always exist in our realities. Even though my father is not here in present, he's always here in spirit, as well as other family members and other spirit guides. And some spirit guides which I have been given, which are not even human, and they also has helped me to understand the evolve, how humans evolve, and how we evolve into a better dimension. I mean better, I mean as in more awareness, no suppression. Anyway, I built up my energies, got my guides on my left and my right, and one behind me. Two angels, one spirit guide, my gatekeeper. Consent into everything that I may want in my will. Beautiful rainbow starting off with. All the stuff, all the symbols, all the patterns, all the geometric patterns, all the vibration, feelings, thoughts, feelings. It's all symbolic. It's all symbolic. It's all frequency. If you've got the attention with that symbolic, you know, the symbolic, they engage with each other, and if it's positive, it'll work. If it's negative, it will fire back and it won't work. And you know when you're doing it in love and light, because you've got only happy thoughts. And happy thoughts are happy vibrations, and happy vibrations are high. And the higher vibrations, more guides, different guides of different priorities come to assist to us on our journeys. As we develop, they develop, and we get all the different spirit guides for different missions in our lifetime. While in this lifetime I've got many different things to do before I pass into spirit, but mainly right now in my lifetime I'm just seeing that healing and just giving that healing as much as I can whenever I can, and taking it easy. So remember, if you know someone been suffering and is suffering with COPD, which is a chronic lung disease, and it can cause, and it does, and it will cause death. And remember, death is only a part of the transition which humans will not understand, because our brains are not wired to understand. That's why if you want to understand death, the transition of evolution, and then you need to research the history before you start researching conspiracies. Once you research the history and the secret societies and how they've operated, how magic works, all the opportunities in the universe comes your way. And you just take that opportunity, that chance when you want, in which I am. 27 years old, and I'm hoping I'll continue this for a very, very long time. I'm sure I will. Namaste, and love and light be with you always.